Hi, my name is Rex Venator. I am a bounty hunter with Bailspeak.com. I am currently sitting on a 2013 Softail Slim, and there is another piece of equipment that I added to this bike in combination and in conjunction with other parts that I put on the bike that I wanted to share with you all today. Now, this 2013 Softail Slim has the Vance & Hines Big Shots Longs. Of course, it has the Screamin Eagle Heavy Breather. It also has Screamin Eagle 204 cams installed. Now, the cams caused the bike to run just a little hot, so I had to try to find a solution to bring the temperature of the bike down, especially since summer's coming, and I didn't want to run into any overheating problems while running the bike with such hot cams. Now, it may not be clearly evident at first glance, and that was kind of the idea, I decided to get an oil cooler. If you take a look, right here, here's the oil cooler. So this Jagg oil cooler was very interesting. First off, it wasn't that difficult to install. I did it myself. Secondly, I would say that there was a 20 to 30 degree temperature drop, whether I was traveling, whether I came to a stop, when I shut the bike off. As a matter of fact, the bike used to shut off at about 210 degrees, and that was when it was pretty cold. Now it's 70, 75, it's shutting off, it's never going past 200. I've also noticed a remarkable improvement in the bike's performance with the Jagg oil cooler. Now, if you are a 2012 or 2013 Softail Slim Harley Davidson owner, and you decide to install the Screamin Eagle cams, whether they be the 204 or maybe a slightly hotter cam, the bike may run hot. If that's the case, you may want to consider an oil cooler as well. It'll help with the bike's performance. My strong suggestion, and understand that I've only installed one oil cooler on this bike, is the Jagg oil cooler. Thank you for taking just a minute or two to hear what I had to say regarding the 2013 Softail Slim and the Jagg oil cooler. And you all, stay safe out there.